Hello, rail fans, and welcome to French Fried Trains. Today, we're going to be continuing on with our fantasy CP rail passenger train, and we're going to be building the passenger cars for it. And we're going to be learning how to build these Hyundai Rotem bi-level coach cars here. And then at the end of the video, I'm going to show you how to modify one into this cab car for the end of the train here. But before we get started, make sure you help out the channel by liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing the video wherever possible to help grow this channel's reach. And if you really want to help out a struggling YouTuber and help the channel be able to continue making videos every day, we now have Super Thanks available, so you can hit the Super Thanks button and make a small donation to help keep this channel going and supplement the tiny amount of money I get from YouTube. But if not, your likes and views are thanks enough. Now, let's get on to our video here. So we already did the locomotive here in yesterday's video. So we're gonna come behind here with a dark oak stair for the coupler and attach that up on the second layer in the middle. Under it, a sideways dark oak vent skate. Then on the next block back, on the bottom, we need to do a row 5 wide of smooth quartz top slabs. Then we're gonna put one here and one here. Then on the second layer, we're gonna put 5 netherite blocks across here. Then an upside down smooth quartz stair above the slab on each side facing outward. Then come in here and we're gonna open a fence gate on either side of this coupler on the second layer. Then we'll go on the next block behind these stairs and put a fence gate on each rail on bottom. Behind that, a netherite wheel on each rail. Then a deep slate brick wall in the middle. Then a 3x3 of walls in the middle. Then one in the center and a netherite wheel here and here. Then we're gonna go through and put a wither skeleton skull on all 4 netherite wheels. Then we're gonna add a fence gate here and here and a grindstone in the middle. Repeat on this side. Next, take out black stone brick block and we'll come up on this second layer and go 3 wide in the middle here. And we're gonna bring it over till it's over these inner wheels right here. Then on the side of this second layer above the wheel, we're gonna put an upside down smooth quartz stair facing the end of the car like this and a row of smooth quartz top slabs across here. Repeat on this side, so an upside down stair facing this way here and a row of top slabs across here. Just like that. Now come on bottom behind this and put a 3x3 of cyan terracotta in the center. Then we're gonna add a quartz stair upside down going this way here and 2 white concrete. Same thing here, an upside down stair going this way here, then 2 white concrete here. Then we're gonna come behind this on top of the rail on bottom and we're gonna do a line of cyan terracotta coming back, and that's going to be 23 blocks long in total. 2, 3. And once you have it 23 blocks long, we're just gonna extend this across to the other rail so it's 3 wide in the middle of cyan terracotta, all down to this end. Then right here, we're gonna put 2 upside down quartz stair facing outward, and then 2 here. Then we're gonna move down to this end and put 2 upside down quartz stair facing outward here, and then 2 here. Then next to this, a row of white concrete across this bottom outer edge. And same thing on this side, a row of white concrete across this edge as well. And then we're gonna move back down to this end on the bottom middle and do a 3x3 of cyan terracotta here. Then we'll put 2 white concrete here and an upside down stair facing this way, how it is on that side, but the opposite end. So an upside down stair facing this way here, and then 2 white concrete and an upside down stair here. Then on top of these 2 quartz stairs, put 2 mangrove doors here, 2 on top of these ones, and then just copy that over to this other side. Then next to this door, we're gonna do 2 rows of 3 red concrete on the side and 2 rows of 3 on this side. Then on this side of the door, a single line of red concrete across the outer edge down to this other door. Then 2 rows of 3 here, 2 rows of 3 here, and then another single line of red concrete across this side on the bottom outer edge as well. Then behind this, we're going to put another 8-wheel on each rail, in the middle a deep slate brick wall, then a 3x3 of walls behind it. Then one in the middle, another 8-wheel here and here. Then go through, put a wither skeleton skull on all four netherite wheels, then a fence gate here and here, grindstone in the middle. Repeat on this side, so wither skeleton skull on the ends, fence gate here and here, grindstone in the middle. Then we're going to come behind this and put a fence gate on the back of these two wheels. Then we're going to skip one block back so there's an empty gap of space, and on the second block out, we're going to go 5 wide of smooth quartz top slabs on the bottom layer. Then we'll add one slab here and one here. Across the end here, put 5 netherite, then an upside down smooth quartz stair here and here. In the middle, go 3 wide with blackstone brick block and bring it in till it's over this inner wheel right here. Then we'll come out here on the second layer and put an upside down stair facing this way, here and here. Then a row of smooth quartz top slabs across this, and a row of smooth quartz top slabs across this. Then on the end, take a dark oak stair for the coupler, turn around, stack it up to this middle second block. Under it, we're going to put a sideways fence gate. We're also going to open a fence gate on either side of the coupler. Now we'll come up on this next layer, and we're going to do a line of red concrete across the outer edge to the end here, and then and on this side here. In the middle, we're going to put a white concrete here and here, and a red in the middle. Then 3 iron trap doors here, then a mangrove door on the middle, then a 2x2 red and white checkerboard pattern on either side of the door. Then continue the checkerboard pattern up one, 5 wide up here. Then take blackstone brick wall, come up and over the door like this. Then go 5 wide and continue our checkerboard pattern, another 2 blocks tall above here. Then finally put a crimson button on each top corner. And we're going to repeat that whole process on the other end. So we're going to come down here with red concrete. And we'll come across this outer edge here to the end. Then same thing here. Then we're going to add a red concrete in the middle, white here and here, 3 trapdoors of iron here. Then a mangrove door in the middle, and a 2x2 red and white concrete checkerboard pattern on either side. Then go 5 wide up here and continue the checkerboard pattern. Take blackstone brick wall, come up each side of the door and across the top. Then go 5 wide up here and continue the checkerboard pattern another 2 blocks tall up here. And finally a crimson button on each top corner. Now we're going to come down here next to these side doors on the bottom outer edge. And we're going to put 2 red concrete here, then 2 next to these doors. Then we're going to go 3 black stained glass panes, red concrete. 3 stained glass panes, red concrete. 3 stained glass panes, red concrete, and 3 stained glass panes. So there should be 4 3 block wide windows. Then just come to this side, copy the pattern of red concrete directly across, and then fill in all 4 of these windows with black stained glass panes. Then we're going to go down on the end, on this top outer edge, and we'll start right here. And just do a full single line of red concrete coming all the way across the top of these windows and bring it right down to the other end of the car. And we're going to repeat on this side and do another full line of red concrete all the way across this top outer edge as well. Just like that. Now, in this corner, I'm going to put a single black concrete on this left-hand corner of each side, then a single white concrete, then 2 black stained glass panes on either side, then a single red concrete, then 2 stained glass panes again. Then we're going to move down to the other end. And on this end, we're going to do 2 red concrete in each corner, then 2 black stained glass panes, then a red concrete, then 2 black stained glass panes again. Then finally, do a full line of red concrete all the way across this top to the other end. And then repeat over here and do a full line of red concrete all the way across the top of this side as well. Now we're going to move back down to this left-hand side. And in each of these corners, we're going to put a 2x2 of black concrete. Then in front of that, a column of 2 white concrete on each side. Then in front of that, a column of two red concrete. In front of that, a single white concrete on each side, and then a red on each top corner. Then we're gonna come up here above this first window divider from the left on this top outer edge. Put a single red concrete here and one on this side. Then we're gonna come over here above this right-hand window and put a red concrete above the left-hand block of this window here and here. Then fill the middle of this all with red concrete and same thing here. Then on the side of it, do a full line of white concrete down to the end of the car here. And same thing on that side, a full line of white concrete across there. Then we'll go to this other side of it, and we'll also do a full line of white concrete here. And a full line of white concrete over here. Then on the next layer, we're going to start from this left-hand corner right here and do white concrete until it's over this first red concrete block right here. Then repeat on this side. Then we're going to do red concrete and come over until it's above this first white concrete block on each side like this. And then finally, white concrete all the way down to the end on this side. And then a full line of white concrete all the way across this side as well here. Then up in this left-hand corner here, we're gonna put a black concrete here and here. And then a white concrete here and here. Then take black stained glass panes, and we're gonna copy our pattern of 4 3-block wide windows directly up aligned with the ones on bottom. All with a gap of space between them. Then on this end, we're gonna add 2 more 3-block wide windows with a gap of space. And we'll repeat over here and add 2 more 3-block wide windows with a gap of space. Then red concrete across here, and a single red concrete between all these windows. And then red concrete across here as well. Then we'll just come to this side and just copy our pattern of red concrete directly across exactly the same way. And then go ahead and fill all the windows on this side, each with 3 black stained glass panes. Then this actually needs to raise up 1 more layer. So we're gonna come on top of the end and continue this red and white checkerboard pattern up 1 more block. And same thing down here on this end, continue the checkerboard pattern up 1 more block. And then finally, we're gonna come all the way across this top outside edge with a full line of red concrete all the way down to the other end of the car. And repeat on this side and do a full line of red concrete all the way across the top edge of this side as well, going end to end here. And now that we have most of the car framed in, before we do the details, we're going to go ahead and go inside the car and start doing the interior here. Up on this mid deck in the end, start here, go 3 wide with cyan terracotta and bring it to the end of this blackstone brick block. Repeat for the other end and add a layer 3 wide of cyan terracotta here to the end of this blackstone brick block. Then on this left hand side, a 2x2 of quartz, then 2 here. Put an end portal here, turn around and put a door over it. Then take polished deep slate stairs and make 2 stairs going up there. Repeat it on this side. So over here, a 2x2 of quartz here, then 2 here, end portal here. Put a door over the end portal, and then 2 polished deep slate stairs here. Then up here, we're gonna put 2 quartz blocks here, 1 here, then 2 up here. Then 2 stairs going this way, a polished deep slate. Repeat on this end. So 2 quartz blocks here, 1 here, 2 up here, and 2 polished deep slate stairs going this way. Then come down here in front of this door, do a column of 4 glass panes behind the door on either side of this. Repeat on this end. Put a column of 4 glass panes here, and 4 here. Then in front of the glass panes, we're gonna put a mangrove stair every other block coming up each side for the seats on this bottom layer. Then right above these windows here. We're going to take iron trap doors and put a row across here, going from one set of glass panes to the other. And repeat on this side and put a row of iron trap doors across here as well. And then we're going to get some lights in here. So above this door here, put three horizontal end rods on this third layer here. And we'll repeat at this end and put three horizontal end rods on this third layer here. Just like that. Then right here, we're going to grab some quartz stairs. And we're going to put two upside down quartz stairs right here. And repeat on this end and put two upside down stairs here. Then up here, we're going to add one more polished deep slate stair going this way. Then on the side of it, on this end, we're going to take cyan terracotta at the same level of this stair and go three wide right here. And we're just going to start bringing that all the way across three wide to make the floor of the second layer. And we're going to bring it right down to this end till it's touching right here and put a polished deep slate stair here. Then we're going to add four cyan terracotta on this side on that same level and four right here. And we'll repeat for the other end. So we'll add four here and then four here. Then we're going to drop down on this mid deck, one block in front of these stairs, and put mangrove stairs every other block, three on each side, like this. Then we're going to roof this in and wall this off. So we're going to take quartz blocks on the same level of this cyan terracotta and go three wide here and bring it across that level all the way to the end. Then right here, we're going to do a 3x3 of quartz blocks coming up. Just like that. And we repeat the whole process on this end. So we'll come down here with mangrove stairs, turn around, put three on each side, every other block like this. Then at the same level up here, go three wide with quartz blocks and fill that in to the end of the car. Then we'll put a 3x3 of quartz blocks here. Then out here, we're going to put three quartz blocks on either side of this. And then three upside down quartz stairs there. Repeat here. So three quartz blocks here, and three upside down stairs on top right here. Then take our mangrove stairs for the top layer seats, start right here, and just go all the way down every other block with a stair on each side for all the seats here. Just like that. And now the interior is complete. Now we're going to do the top. So we're going to come on top of the end, on the middle, put a white concrete here and a red here and here. Repeat on the other end in the middle, so a red concrete here and here, white in the middle. Behind this on top, we're going to do a 3x3 of red concrete on the top middle. And then a 3x3 of deep slate tile blocks. And repeat at this end, so on the top middle down here, a 3x3 of red concrete, then a 3x3 of deep slate tile blocks. Behind this, just go three wide on this top middle with your red concrete, and we're going to bring that all the way down across the top to the other end so that the whole roof gets filled in here. Then on this top outer edge, put four mangrove outward facing stairs on each side, then three deep slate tile stairs here and here. Then come all the way across this with mangrove stairs. Then three deep slate tile stairs here, four mangrove here. Repeat on this side. So four mangrove stairs here, three deep slate tile stairs here, and finally a row of mangrove stairs all the way across the middle of this side as well here. Then up here, we're going to do a 3x4 of red carpet on the top middle. Then a 3x3 of oak trapdoors here. Then behind this, we're just going to fill the whole top middle three wide with our red carpet. Go ahead and bring that all the way down to the other end here. a 3x3 of oak trapdoors here, and then a 3x4 of red carpet on this end here. Now we're going to make some banners. So come into a loom with a white banner and black dye. And we're going to do one each of all four of these triangles. You don't need the diamond one, that was a mistake. Then we're going to come up here and we're going to put this triangle one here and this one above it. Then go to this side and use the opposite ones and put this one like this right here and this one above this. Now come back into a loom again, this time with a red banner and white dye. And once again, we're going to do one each of all four of these triangles. And this is going to make stripes. So we're going to come up here, and right here, we're going to place this one, and we're going to copy that banner every other block till you get here. Then we're going to take this triangle one in between here, and put them like this in between all of them, like that. So it makes these stripes. Then we'll come right here, place this one here, and same thing, every other block across this white concrete till you get here. Then on the end here, we're gonna take this one, put it here, and then in between all of these, like that. Then we will, of course, repeat on this side. So over here, we're gonna take this banner, place it right here, then every other block across this white concrete, then place this one here, and then one in between all these banners. And then one more corner to go. We're gonna place this one here, then every other block across this white concrete here. Then place this one here, and then in between all of these ones as well here. Then on this corner, place a column starting here, coming up of all plain red banners to cover that checkerboard pattern. Repeat at this end and place a column of red banners all right here for this checkerboard pattern. And then same thing right here. And one more corner to go. A column of red banners right here as well. Now we're going to come back into our loom one more time with a red banner and white dye. We're going to put a vertical on the left, horizontal on the top and bottom. New banner, top half white, vertical on the left, new banner. We're gonna do a diagonal, vertical on the left, top half white, new banner. A vertical on each side, a horizontal on the middle and the top. New banner, a vertical in the center, new banner, vertical on the left, horizontal on bottom. Go to red dye, and we're just gonna put a red border around every single one of these letter banners here. Then we're gonna come up here, skip one right here and put CP space rail. Then we will repeat on this other side. We're gonna skip one here, put CP right here, skip one and put rail. And now all the logos are done. So this completes the build for the single Hyundai Rotem bi-level coach car here. So what we need to do next is use the structure command or world edit to copy in, or just build as many of these cars as you want on your train. It's a fantasy train, so it doesn't really matter however much you want. And now I'm gonna show you how to modify the last one into the cab car for the back of the train here. So the first thing we're gonna do is come down on the very bottom here. And we're gonna take off this slab and put an upside down black stone brick stair on each bottom corner facing outward. On the bottom middle here, we need to change these three slabs to right side up black stone brick stairs like that. Then we're gonna come back in here and take off this row of five netherite. And we're gonna change this to five upside down black stone brick stairs all facing forward like this coming across. Next, we're gonna come on here and we need to take these black stone brick walls off Then we're also going to remove these three iron trap doors. Then we're going to take out these middle three blocks right here. We're going to put an upside down inward facing smooth quartz stair here and here, and a mangrove top slab here. Then in this hole, put a white concrete and a red concrete. Then we're going to come on this layer that's under these buttons, and we're going to take out these five here and that whole slice above it all the way up to the top. Just take all this stuff out. This one has a very uniquely shaped cab car. Then right here, we're going to take these two red concrete and this stair off. Then the three on top, this stair, and these two red concrete. Then on the next block back, we're going to take off this one, the stair, these three, this one, and that other one in the corner here. Then here, take off this stair, these three, and this stair. Now up here, we're also going to take off all these deep slate tile stairs, all these deep slate tile blocks, and all these oak trapdoors. Just like that. Then down here on the end, we're going to put a glow item frame on each of these corners with a frog light. Then we're going to put a red concrete on this top middle with a glow item frame and a frog light on that. Then a smooth quartz stair on either side, and then a mangrove stair on each outer edge. Then we're going to add a smooth quartz stair here and here, then a black stained glass block here, then right here, white concrete, red concrete. Then on the next layer, we're going to put a mangrove stair here and here, and then three black stained glass panes between the stairs. Then we're going to come up here one block back and do five mangrove stairs across here, wrap around the corner, three outward facing here, three outward facing here, fill this with a 3x3 of red concrete right here. Then we're going to come down under this headlight and put a dark oak sign here with our number, whichever number you want as it's fantasy, and with a white die, and then a glow ink sack. Then come on the side here. Right here, one block in front of these windows, change these two blocks to put two black stained glass panes. And we'll repeat on this side, change these two right here to two black stained glass panes. Then put a white stained glass pane on the side here, and one on this side here. Then up here, we're going to put a conduit here and here, open a mangrove fence gate, and a sideways one behind it, and fill the rest of this with red carpet on top. And now our exterior modifications are done, and we need to do the interior. So we'll have to come down to this door, come inside here, and we're going to go up these stairs into this mid-deck here. In here on this right-hand side, we're going to knock out this seat and this seat. We're going to put two rows of four quartz blocks here. Then, because of the scale of Minecraft, we don't really have room. So we're gonna have to get up into the cab with a ladder here. So we're gonna put this block knocked out up here so you can get up there, and put three ladders on this wall. Then take out this seat right here, put a column of three quartz blocks here. Then we're gonna put a door over this ladder. Then we'll go through that door and climb up the ladder into the cab here. Up here, we're gonna add three quartz blocks here, then three smooth quartz top slabs right here in front of this windshield. Put two glow item frames with end crystals, and then add a lever here. Then we'll turn around and we're gonna put a stair here and here for the seats inside the cab. And now our interior modifications are done as well here, and we can come back to the bottom level and go back outside. So there we have it, folks. We finally completed our fantasy CP rail passenger train with our MP36 locomotive and our Hyundai Rotem bi-level coach cars and cab car here. I hope everyone enjoyed the build. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And everyone, have a great week. Stay safe out there, rail fans.